Recognizing that I volunteered as a ranger, fully knowing the hazards of my chosen profession, I will always endeavor to uphold the prestige, honor, and highest spirit of corps of my ranger regiment. This is the first stanza of the Ranger Creed, the motto of the 75th Ranger Regiment, a code that all rangers live by and a code which I still strive to live by. From your first day as a ranger, you're expected to memorize it, but it takes time to take it to heart. What does it mean to volunteer? What does it mean to serve? I didn't really know when I enlisted. Honestly, I joined the Army out of boredom. Why not? I didn't want to go to college, I wasn't doing anything better, and I heard the food was pretty good. Trust me, I don't think I actually wanted to go through the hardship and endure all the toiling that you associate when you think about the Army, but I felt I would be better for it. To be a ranger, you have to volunteer 3 times. You got to volunteer to be in the Army, you got to volunteer to be a paratrooper and go through airborne school, and you got to volunteer for Ranger Indoctrination Program if you're an enlisted soldier, or RIP. Some guys in RIP, you could tell, wanted to be there so they could impress people, so they could tell people how cool they are. These guys missed the boat. They didn't make it through. If you want to be there for personal glorification, they've entirely missed the boat. You actually don't know what you're signing up for, I would argue, when you volunteer to be a ranger. But you know it's going to suck, and that it's intended to physically and mentally break you. All right? It's intended to weed out the weak. But that's also why I volunteered. I wanted to know what was within me and how I could respond to such a challenge. You can live a comfortable life. You can go around never challenging yourself, but I contend that that's not really living, and you will never develop yourself to your fullest. So how often do you challenge yourself, and what do you think your limits are? Acknowledging the fact that a ranger is a more elite soldier who arrives at the cutting edge of battle by land, sea, or air, I accept the fact that as a ranger, my country expects me to move further, faster, and fight harder than any other soldier. All right. When you graduate RIP, you can't help but feel the sense of accomplishment. All right, I think I made it. I'm a ranger now. And then you, that lasts about 3 seconds, you arrive in your new platoon, and they put you back in your place. And you're wondering what the heck you just got yourself into again. My first day in Ranger Battalion is pretty much everybody's first day in Ranger Battalion. All 6 of us new guys were led into the laundry room, turned down all the dryers, turned down all the hot water sinks, until it got sauna level temperature. And then we alternated between different exercises until each muscle group failed, past failure, and stopping just long enough to recite stanzas of the Ranger Creed. And then back to carrying your buddy up and down the stairs and more exercises. And we even squeezed in some time for some medical training, giving IVs to each other to prevent heat stroke. You know, standard, first day job stuff. You may not have quit in RIP, but guess what? Nobody else in your new platoon did either. So your new brothers need to find out what is within you, and they got to make sure that you will never, ever quit. This is pretty much every day for your first few months. You're asked to do impossible tasks and then punished for failing. It doesn't seem fair, but you better get over fair. Sorry. You better never even mention the word fair. Instead, just focus on overcoming. You can't actually simulate the stress of combat in a training environment, but if you can give your buddy an IV while your hand is shaking and you're suffering from heat exhaustion yourself and someone's screaming at you, you might just be able to be a valuable member of your team when bullets are flying past your face. It's easy to gripe about how the task at hand is ridiculous. It seems unnecessary. You've done it 1,000 times before. Or how you feel like you're your team leader's clown, just there for his own personal entertainment. And even though those things might seem true, just because you don't understand the meaning of the task doesn't mean that there isn't one. As teenagers, I'm sure you've felt this way. You are quite confident you know everything. I've been there. All right, your homework, your chores, and curfews, for example, may all seem pointless at times, but do you still try? Maybe there's a meaning that you're not seeing. Never shall I fail my comrades. I'll always keep myself mentally alert, physically strong, and morally straight. And I will shoulder more than my share of the task, whatever it may be, 100% and then some. Think of the Rangers as a team. Everybody's depending on each other. As a Ranger, my biggest fear was actually never physical harm or death. It was actually letting the person down next to you. That was the biggest fear. Everything you do, your entire motivation, becomes the people around you. Hardship can expose our selfish tendencies, but when you volunteer to be a ranger, you have to put aside your personal wants and desires for the greater needs of the group. It's easy to volunteer when things benefit you, but will you still volunteer to go above and beyond your actual job when you're tired, when you're hurt, when there's no direct benefit to you? What about if you'll receive no credit for doing so? I think you can tell a lot about someone by who their friends are, kind of like Sam just said. True friendship involves putting others before yourself. And I can see that you're hurting, Ranger buddy. Give me some of that ammunition to carry. I've learned that is the Ranger, the human relationships in our lives that give our lives the greatest meaning. Who do you choose to surround yourself by? Which of the people you call friends would carry some of the weight if you asked them? Which of them would offer without you asking? And what if the decisions you made weren't all about you? Gallantly, will I show the world that I am a specially selected and well-trained soldier. My courtesy to superior officers, neatness of dress, and care of equipment shall set the example for others to follow. Despite all this special training that you've received, right, how does this fully prepare me for combat? It doesn't, and it won't. I don't think you'll ever feel quite ready. I didn't feel ready when it was time to go to Afghanistan. Before, I wanted to complain about how much training. Now I'm thinking, what was I thinking? Give me more. And however unprepared I personally felt, though, I actually never feared for our safety. I trusted my leaders with my life to guide us, to guide all of us, to accomplish each mission safely. So what does it mean to be a leader in the Ranger Regiment? It means, above all, leading by example. It means everyone is held to the same standards. Hypocrisy will get you no respect in the Rangers. It's easy to do the right thing when it benefits you. The truth of the matter is, you always know wrong from right. And doing the right thing is not always so easy, but is demanded if you want to be a Ranger. So what is leadership to you? And would you still do the right thing if no one was looking? Energetically will I meet the enemies of my country. I shall defeat them on the field of battle, for I am better trained and will fight with all my might. Surrender is not a Ranger word. I'll never leave a fallen comrade to fall into the hands of the enemy, and under no circumstances will I ever embarrass my country. And Rip, you spent a lot of time trying to memorize these words, to memorize the Ranger Creed, but you don't understand what it means to live the Creed. But you arrive in Ranger Battalion, and you see people living and breathing this Ranger Creed. It guides their life, and this helps you to learn how to internalize it as well. The high moral standards of the Rangers set them apart as much as their level of training. It's not always easy to live up to such high standards 24 hours a day, and many good men who have made a single mistake find themselves leaving their beloved home and saying hello to the regular army. Rangering is hard, but so is life. You have to earn the privilege to belong every day as a Ranger, and with every day, you learn to live by the creed. You'll have to earn your way through life as well, failing all along the way. And if you want to be loved, and if you want respect, you'll have to earn these as well, all throughout your life, from the people in your lives. This is a photo of a man who lost his leg below the knee and refused to quit and refused to leave the Army, made every effort he could to stay in. And he is still an Army Ranger to this day. So readily will I display the intestinal fortitude required to fight onto the Ranger objective and complete the mission, though I be the lone survivor. Life takes courage, and it doesn't get easier once you make sergeant, once you graduate, once you become an adult. In fact, it gets harder. You will have more responsibility placed upon you. It takes courage to do the right thing, and if you stand by your principles, you should know that at some point you'll probably be standing alone. So let me leave you with this question. What creed do you live your life by? Are you aware of the principles that guide your life? Has this been something you've ever even thought about? If you could pick a creed for the world to live by, what would it be? Thank you.